Hello and welcome to a new Azure vlog. In this one, we are going to explore Cloud Firewall. This is a feature which is currently in preview and it's some kind of firewall. It sits between those network virtual appliances of Check Point, Palo Alto, Barracuda and the network security group. So let's grab my laptop, let's prepare a demo environment and also have a good cup of coffee and let's have some fun with the firewall. It's always good to combine a good cup of coffee and Azure. I like them both a lot. So let me first introduce you to the demo environment that I've set up. I created a virtual network with two VMs. Let's focus on that virtual network. If we go to subnets, you'll see that I have three subnets deployed. A subnet for jump box purposes and a server subnet. The other subnet, Azure Firewall subnet, is the subnet where we are going to deploy the firewall in a couple of minutes. It has to be that specific name. So if you have any name convention, forget it. You have to use that name. In the Jumpbox subnet, I've deployed my Jumpbox, which holds a public IP address. And in my server subnet, I've deployed a server which doesn't have a public IP address. I will connect to my server from out of my jump box. To demonstrate that to you, let's connect to my jump box. Here I am in my jump box. And in my jump box, I have a remote desktop session set up to a virtual machine that acts as a server. When I go to the internet, I'm able to go everywhere. For example, twitter.com, github.com. It's all possible right now. There are no restrictions. And that is a thing that we can change with the Azure Firewall. We can implement application rules which prohibits from going to Twitter, GitHub, all kind of websites and allow only a certain amount of websites. That's the current environment. Let me now show you how we can set up the Azure Firewall. So let's go to the Azure portal for that. Let's go to my resource group where I've deployed all these demo resources. Let's click on the add button and let's search for firewall. The name of the Azure firewall in the Azure marketplace is firewall. So click on that one. Let's click create. In order to work with the Azure Firewall, your subscription needs to be registered for this public preview. And you can do that really easy by running two PowerShell commandlets. I have put a URL in the description of this video and it tells you what commands you run and how you can run them. In this demo, I already have run those commands on one of my subscriptions. I will use that subscription and let's call this firewall firewall01. Let's put it in an existing resource group. Let's deploy it in West Europe. Let's use an existing network. Let's create a new public IP address. Azure Vlog Firewall we are using as DNS name label. Let's review this thing. Here we have a summarization of the data that we just entered in the portal. Let's hit create. So now Azure is creating the firewall resource for us. And this will take a couple of minutes. Thanks to the magic of movie editing, my Azure firewall has been deployed right now. So let's go and let's see what we have. Here I have the firewall. and it has a private IP address. We will need that in a couple of minutes. At the moment it has no rules. Everything is blocked by default, except from some default rules to let your VMs function on Azure, so they can report their diagnostic logs, etc. We have a network rule collection and we have an application rule collection. The network rule collection is a collection of basic network rules. Rules that you can compare with rules that you would use in network security groups. So block a certain protocol, allow a certain IP address on a certain protocol to access your resource. The application rule collection is something different. Here we can filter on the FQDN, the domain name of a service to which it is going. We can block, for example, amazon.com or github.com or etc. We can do that with application rules. So now our firewall is deployed. We have seen the basic properties of it. Let's make sure that it is working, because the traffic of our VM is still not going through this firewall. All traffic from our VM is directly going to the Azure gateways and from there to the internet. We need to make sure that the traffic from our VM is going to the firewall and from there to the internet. In order to do so, we can use a user-defined route. So let's deploy that one. In our resource group, let's click on the add button. Let's search for route table. We will find a route table. Let's click on create. Let's give it a name to Azure Firewall. Let's use an existing resource group, Cloud Firewall resource group that we use to deploy all the resources for this demo. Let's click on create. And within a couple of seconds, our user-defined route is in place. But when it's in place, it's still not attached to our virtual network and we haven't set up any route yet. So we need to do that right away. So our route table is ready. Let's click on go to resource. Let's add a route. Route name to Azure Firewall. Address prefix 0.0.0.0/0 to a virtual appliance, and the IP address of my virtual appliance, my Azure Cloud Firewall, is the 10.1.0.4. So this route will make sure that all traffic is forwarded to the Azure Firewall. Now the Azure portal is adding the route to the route table resource. Once that is complete, we are going to associate the route table with our subnet. And we do that by going to the subnet page, click on associate. Let's select our virtual network. Also, let's select our subnet. In this case, we are going to apply this route table on our server subnet. Now that's associated, and it might take some minutes in order to be effective. Let's check if it's already active. Let's go to my virtual machine. Let's start the internet browser and let's go, for example, to amazon.com. What you see here is a message, HTTP request blocked by Azure Firewall. So the Azure Firewall is in place and it's now denying our access to amazon.com. If you are going to the Azure portal, let's go to the resource group where our firewall is deployed. Let's click on the firewall. Let's go to rules. There is no application rule collection right now. Let's create an application rule collection which allows us to visit amazon.com. Allow amazon.com. Let's give it a priority, example 200. Allow olaoalazen.com. For our source address, let's use the address space for our subnet in which the server is deployed. Protocol use HTTP. The target star.msn.com. Let's add this one. Now it's updating the Azure firewall and this may take a minute. Okay, now our rule has been added. Let's go back to the virtual machine. Let's test if we can go to msn.com right now. Although it's saying the page is not available right now, this is a page that's served by msn.com. We only allow amazon.com now as domain, but there are maybe some kind of trackers, cookies, things that require other domains to be allowed. Those are blocked at the moment. So that's possibly the reason that Amazon is serving this page right now. Also, let's add another domain. If you go to udonisen.com, that one is also blocked. Let's go to the firewall. Let's add a new application rule. Allow Jeroen.com priority 300. Allow Jeroen.com. Again, for the source address, we use our subnet port HTTP star.jeroen.com. Also, let's add that one. So, let's check if my site is working right now. It's loading. Here it is. Jeroen.com served via the Azure firewall. What we see on this page is quite interesting. There are two vlogs over here and those are hosted on YouTube. We haven't allowed the domain of youtube.com, so those are not served in here. With that, I would like to end this demo. We have deployed the Azure firewall. We have set up a user-defined route to make sure that traffic from our server is going through the firewall to the internet. By default, everything is blocked in that firewall. We allowed two domains, msn.com and my website jeroen.com, to be served. And we saw that that was working. So in this vlog, we learned about Azure Firewall. It is a firewall solution provided by Microsoft. It sits somewhere in the middle between network security groups and the firewall solutions that are provided by third-party vendors like Barracuda, Checkpoint, Palo Alto, etc. It's Microsoft's first solution that allows us to filter outbound traffic. Traffic that's going from our virtual network to the public internet. It's the first solution for Microsoft that allows us to do filtering on that kind of traffic. The service is still in preview. So things you've seen today in this Azure vlog might be different when Azure Firewall hits general availability. And with that, I would like to close this Azure vlog. I will put some links in the description related to the Azure Firewall, how you can set it up, etc. If you have any questions, please use the comments for that. If you like this one, please hit the thumbs up button and also subscribe to this channel. And of course, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.